First ask questions to Mr. Wang Zhu Yan, the chairman of Pharmaly Pharmaceutical. Mr. Yan, are you there?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I'm present.
Yes, in the previous hearing, I remember September 10, I was asking you these questions, and we moved for the committee to subpoena records of the payment of contributions of SSS, PhilHealth, and Pag-ibig. We received certifications from SSS, for example, dated September 13, which says Pharmaly only started paying SSS contributions for its employees for the month of November 2020. Sir Chairman, doon lang po sila nagsimula magbayad nitong government mandated contributions. Yung PhilHealth po, ganun din ho, confirm po as of September 10, 2021. At yung Pag-ibig, if you can also show yung Pag-ibig certification, September 24, 2021. Ayan po. Sabi din ho, nagsimula lang silang mag-contribute November 2020. This is not the same answer that you have given me, sir, when I ask you if you are contributing with the government-mandated contribution. So my question, Mr. Zhu Yan, did you have employees at Pharmaly from September 2019 to October 2020? If you have any employees.
Mr. Chairman, if I may elaborate, a bulk of our employees, just to name a few, were transferred from Philippine Biological Company as that company was defunct. I believe at that time we were paying the contributions still in Pharmaly Biological, and it is a mere administrative delay.
Can I just be very quick in getting your answer? Do you have employees in Pharmaly? So if it is not Pharmaly, then you don't have any employees. Is that correct, sir?
I was not, Mr. Chairman, if I may.
The answer is just yes or no. If you have employees in Pharmaly from September 2019 to October 2020. That's just my question, sir. Very simple question.
Mr. Chairman, I believe there are employees, but they were rightfully compensated with Pag-ibig, perhaps in the wrong entity. If this is so, I apologize. There was a transfer for some of our employees. As I said, the Pharmaly Biological Company was in defunct. However, we still paid. I think the company is still paid.
Sir, you're saying there are employees, but according to these records, you were not paying government-mandated contributions. Now, do you know a certain Ana Marie Chua?
Yes.
Ana Marie Chua. She was one of your employees at Pharmaly. Is that correct?
That's correct, Mr. Chairman.
Yes. When was she hired?
I don't have the exact records of that, Mr. Chairman. I apologize.
Because in April 2020, her position in the company, April 2020, her position in the company was Regulatory Affairs Pharmacist. Is this correct?
Yes, I do believe that's correct.
Yes. So my question now is she a regular full-time employee of Pharmaly, sir?
She was a regular full-time employee of Pharmaly, I believe.
Okay. So again, sir, if she is a regular employee of Pharmaly, as you just mentioned she is, and confirmed that she is a regular employee, with the documents that I showed you, with Pag-ibig, with SSS, with PhilHealth, you are not contributing from this government mandated contributions. So you are now confirming that despite the fact that she is a regular employee, I showed you all the documents, April 2020, she's a pharmacist, she is a um, What's her position again? She has a position of being your regulatory affairs pharmacist. You are not contributing for her PAG-IBIG, PhilHealth, and SSS.
If I
Correct?
may, would the Honorable Senator please clarify, is she referring to now? Is Anna Maria Chua still an employee of the company now? And the answer will be no. I think she resigned from the company, I think.
Sorry, I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry. I'm asking about the dates that I have given you. I showed you September 2020, April 2020. She's already working with the company as a regular employee. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, what I'm trying to drive at, Mr. Chairman, is that indeed they are not contributing with the government mandated contributions with PhilHealth, SSS, and PhilHealth, SSS, Mr. Chairman, and other government institutions. Another question that I'd like you to answer, sir, is if you have no employees, because it seems you have no employees. Sometimes you say you have employees, sometimes you don't. Now, if you don't have employees, if you look at the general and administrative expenses of Pharmaly in 2020, there, can you make it bigger there? But I wanted to find out, Sangha, where's this employees benefits come from? Because you don't have employees, you are not contributing to SSS, GS, I mean SSS, PhilHealth, PAG-IBIG. You're not contributing. So what is this employees benefits of 1.3 million?
Mr. Chairman, based on my memories, I believe all the employees, perhaps there was a delay in signing them the correct under the right company. However, they're always rightfully compensated by the companies, and also their benefits are rightfully compensated in accordance with our contracts with them. I don't think any of the employees have ever lodged a report on this with us. And if they were to, we would have rightfully addressed it. But
it's either, sir, you are fooling your employees or you're fooling the government or both. Unfortunately, these records would not lie. Mr. Chairman, I am just stating this, not only because of the fact that Pharmaly only hired 7 to 11 employees. But during this time, Mr. Chairman, in this committee emphasized the importance of hiring Filipinos first. In our Bayanihan 2, the law that we passed, Mr. Chairman, unahin dapat ang Pilipino. Doon sa statements ng CONWEP, Confederation of Wearable Exporters of the Philippines, nag-repurpose po sila. Ginawa nila lahat ng magagawa nila para maka-hire ng mga Pilipino. Pero ano ho nangyari noong 2020, ang statement ng CONWEP, they lost 25,000 jobs, Mr. Chairman. 25,000 jobs. Ang kapalit, ito ho, hindi ho nagbibigay o nagko-contribute sa mga government-mandated agencies ng kanilang contributions. At yung huling record na nakita natin, 7 hanggang 11 empleyado lamang, Mr. Chairman, yung nagawa at nalikhang trabaho. I wanted to ask you another question, Mr. Chu Yen. Last hearing, again, last September 10, when this representation asked you where you got the money to finance your initial order of 2.4 million pieces of face masks with the total value of 54 million. Since I showed you the audited financial statements, I did not see any loans in your 2020 audited financial statements, and I'm sure you will confirm that. Your answer to this representation was, and I quote, "We have access to the inventories of our suppliers. And what we do is we negotiate preferential payment terms with these inventories, with these suppliers, so that we can get the stock on hand. Close quote. Just to clarify, sir, you negotiated preferential payment terms for these inventories with suppliers such as, and this came out during the hearing, such as Tiger Field Marketing. Is that correct, Your Honor?
Mr. Chairman, yes, Tiger Field was one of the
suppliers. The next question, yes. So Tiger Field Marketing is included with the number of suppliers that you were mentioning. Now, my question is, what are the terms? What are the terms under this so-called negotiated preferential payment terms? I wanted to know that because during the hearing, then USEC Law and DOH were saying they will not pay any supplier unless they were able to check on it, inspect on it, and they were able to get it. That's the only time that they will be paying. So again, these so-called negotiated preferential payment terms, can you explain that to us?
Mr. Chairman, with some of our suppliers, what we were able to do is they would be able to supply just the necessary inventories to us to deliver to the government. And we have never received a single advance payment from the government for any of the projects. And only after their inspection and their approval, when we receive collection, we will pay back these suppliers.
Yes, that's what I already mentioned, Mr. Wang Tsui-yen. My question is, what are the terms with you, with Farmily, and these suppliers with these so-called negotiated preferential payment terms? Because if I am a supplier, don't you think it is kind of weird and odd for suppliers to be giving you all these units, these supplies, without knowing whether or not you can pay because you only have 625,000 assets, cash on hand?
I believe, Mr. Chairman, we would, in some instances, we would tell them that these supplies are for the government purchases. And I believe that the common understanding is that there is confidence in the government that once conditions of the contracts are made, that payment will be made. I think the general confidence in the government yes. is high, and therefore they are willing.
Sir, yes, thank you for that. The confidence is with the government. But how did they earn your confidence with Farmily? I mean, don't you think it's something weird there? Or fishy that a supplier would give you all that without knowing that you have a backer? For instance, the Tiger Field Marketing. Is that the case with Tiger Field Marketing? They are just they just trust Farmily that despite that they are not contributing government mandated contribution, they only have 625,000 peso capital, and now first order you have 54 million pesos worth of a project. And then with balloon to 8 billion pesos, there's something there for sure that they would have that confidence with Farmily.
Mr. Chairman, I cannot speak for the minds of our suppliers, but I just wish to state on record that we have no disputes with any of our suppliers on payments, and we have acted on all contractual obligations in good faith with the government and with the suppliers.
Okay, no, we will ask the suppliers later, Tiger Field. But can I ask you one more question? Other than Tiger Field Marketing, who are your suppliers, other suppliers? And is it the same similar arrangement with this negotiated preferential payment terms that pay whenever? We don't know when are we going to pay you. And we only have 625,000 capital. And yes, we have billions and billions of projects. Is it the same similar arrangement with these suppliers? Who are these suppliers other than Tiger Field Marketing?
Mr. Chairman, if I may, it's very difficult for us at this point to divulge these details because as we have seen in this hearing, any supplier, any name we name, they are brought to the Senate and they are scrutinized. Their suppliers are scrutinized. I'll beg the question, is anything that everybody buy from the manufacturer, is that there is a necessity need of distributors or traders in this, because they bear the risk. Because in this instances, the government pays only after food delivery. And therefore, it's very hard. You know, the company names are very dragged through the mud with this Senate hearing. But we still have our personal reputation to uphold as a business person. We need to uphold the confidential.
If you don't want to do so, I will submit to the wisdom of the chair and the committee on whether or not these suppliers will be named. Again, Mr. Chairman, we are pursuing this question only because of the fact that 25,000 kababayans natin, mga Pilipino, nawalan ng trabaho dahil hindi nabigay sa kanila itong kontrata, hindi sila na bigyan ng preferential treatment considering sila yung kababayan natin, considering ito ang nasa konstitusyon, considering ito ang nasa ating batas. Hinahanap lang natin, Mr. Chairman, yung dahilan kung bakit sa kanila ibinigay, despite the fact, Mr. Chairman, na wala silang ganong kalaking kapital. At muli, babanggitin ko, nakakapagtaka masyado, Mr. Chairman, na itong mga suppliers na to will trust formally with 625,000 na ibigay lahat ng supplies nila, ibigay lahat worth billions of pesos without knowing what's going to happen, without knowing kung mababayaran ba sila, may kapasidad ba itong formally na ito na pahiramin nila ng ganitong kadaming supply. And it's just weird, Mr. Chairman, na walang guarantor ito. Is there a guarantor, Mr. Chu Yen, that you made mention with these suppliers, that you have a guarantor that in case formally failed to pay the suppliers, a guarantor would pay them?
No, Mr. Chairman, based on our statements by me and Mr. Lin Kong Ong, for some projects, Mr. Michael Yang acted as a guarantee with the Chinese suppliers. I don't know the exact negotiation of the form of guarantee that was made, but they were more than willing to release the goods to us and to help with the fight of COVID in the Philippines so that the goods can reach the hands. And then we would be able to pay them after we have received collection.
So in some cases, Mr. Michael Yang is your guarantor. But in other cases, who else would you say would be willing to be you're using as a guarantor other than Michael Yang? Are there any other personalities?
Based on my recollection, none.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. That's all I'd like to raise, Mr. Chairman, again. Just to emphasize, Mr. Chairman, that again, in 2020, 25,400 Filipinos lost their jobs in this one group alone of local manufacturer. Ito po yung CONWEP, Confederation of Wearable Exporters of the Philippines. Tapos yung pumalit, 7 hanggang 11 lang yung employees na hire. At for the longest time, hindi nagbabayad ng contributions ng SSS, PhilHealth, Pag-ibig. Meron po talagang gaps. Ayusin itong mga ito. Kaya po tayo nagpa-participate sa hearing ng Blue Ribbon. Maraming salamat, Mr. Chairman, and God bless us all.
Thank you very much, Senator Joel Villanueva. Your point.